Soula was born on April 21, 1983, under the name of Athanasia Petrakis after her grandfather Thanasi, and was immediately accepted by the world and was ready to conquer it. Born in Canada into a Greek-Canadian family, she was the youngest of three.
I grew up in Newmarket, and none of you know where that is. It's north of Toronto. And we've been a very tight-knit family. My brother, my sister, my mom, I, my dad have always been very close. Growing up as a kid, I remember always having a mushroom fest. My mom gave me a mushroom fest. It's all I remember a lot about when I was younger. I do remember my brother always picking on me, always beating me up. And I remember my sister always being, one of the sisters that would pick on me with my brother. My brother was always the older brother that always protected me. He'd always protect my sister as well. But anytime anybody would ever try to hit on me or try to talk to me or do anything, my brother would be in there. He'd be there to say, hey, get away from her. Or he wouldn't even say anything. He would give him a look, one of those, go talk to her. My sister was always the one that would be there to take my fall. She'd always be there to coach me or give me advice on what I needed or how I would get something done. She was the one that I looked up to. She's always made me feel like she'll always be there no matter what. And she didn't used to pick on me a lot on Miracle when we were younger. My parents, I would say were the best parents. They've raised me with morals and ethics and have raised me to be who I am today.
Wake up in the morning feeling like P. Diddy.
Hey, what up, girl?
Grab my glasses, I'm out the door, I'm gonna hit this.
Soula, or to some people Sia, enjoyed the spotlight and would attend all the hot spots and popular social gatherings of celebrities. With her friends by her side, they were always the light of the party.
Trying on all our clothes, boys blowing up our phones, dropped up and playing our favorite CDs.
After being noticed for modeling and movie gigs, Soula quickly made the front covers of some of the most famous magazines and also started some well-known films. Soula then tested out the dating scene for a while with some of Hollywood's top men.
You know, she's so widely known as an innately lovable person.
Yes.
You know, with a big smile and a big laugh and a jovial outlook on life.
But love did not bite until May long weekend 2010 when she met the one. Andy Karostinos was quick to capture the heart of Soula.
Come here, ooh, boy, is she big enough?
Take it, baby. When I first met him, was his, let's say, personality. his physique. I was attracted to Andy physically. I found him to be very attractive. He has a very outgoing part of him. He pushes me to do other things. He is kind. He makes me laugh. He always makes me smile, no matter what. Even when I'm sad, he'll make me smile. at the end of the day, he makes me feel like I'm loved.
And what can we say about Andy? He does it all.
He's a really great guy. You know, I think I didn't know what to expect. I think in meeting him, because he's one of those people you hear about. They seem like they just seem very far away. They don't seem real.
Yeah.
And he's extremely down to earth, and he's just goofy and funny and very good. And at the end of the day, we spent most of the time competing. We still argue about who's a better shot and who's
really?
A better, you know, yeah. I'm not
afraid. Yeah.
Andy was born on June 7th, 1983, under the name Andrea Keras Dimos, after his grandfather, and was the youngest of four. His military experience led to many achievements, such as training and also being in some of Hollywood's blockbusters.
Basically, about myself and growing up, I was the youngest of four kids, so I kind of was the spoiled one. But I also had the short end of the stick, because I didn't really have brothers and sisters growing up, because they were a lot older, right? So I pretty much had just my friends and stuff like that. And then age 11, joined cadets, and then from there off, year Army came about. Well, the sports came in to play big time around grade 6, football, soccer, track and field. That was the key. Football was the shining light.
We enjoyed being around each other, and whenever you have like a bond like that, a brotherhood like that, it carries over to the field.
I really didn't know what to expect, you know, as far as, you know, practice, being around him every day, what he was going to be like, you know, as far as a teammate, you know, someone off the field. And, you know, he's probably exceeded every expectation I had. I mean, he's been absolutely awesome. You know, I think he has probably one of the hardest work ethics that I've ever seen.
And true love was born.
He's so delicious. You're so soft. Sweet on the tip of my tongue, you taste like sunlight and strawberry bubble gum. You bite my lip, you spike my blood, and you make my heart
beat. If I could have a relationship like that one day, that is the one to have. I've never seen two people who are together for so long laugh as much as they do. They are constantly making each other laugh. It's sickening, frankly. They're so happy, it's insane. It's like they've been together for 5 weeks. It's pretty great.
If I had to paint a picture of an ideal who I'd want, it'd be her. The only thing I'd have to add is from this step forward, we just have a journey to live up to. And just make each other happy and push forward whatever life brings us. We are looking for, and if I had to pick anything else, like I said pretty much earlier, if I had to sculpt a girl inside out with a checklist on, and I had to make her fill out a checklist, or if I had to put up a piece of artwork and mold what an ideal girl I want, she would be standing with me today.
So I can't control myself, make me alive.